In that video, you are going to create your first OpenGL application Android with Android Studio. For a first application, what's better than creating an Hello World application? So, to start, we are going to define the OpenGL version required for our application in the Android manifest of our application. We define an uses feature tag, and we set the OpenGL version 2.0. Then we are going to create our OpenGL view deriving from the GL surface view object of the OpenGL API offered by the Android SDK. Our class extend GL surface view object. We override the both constructors. We define an init method. In the init method, we have just to look at the first call. We set the OpenGL ES version used. This is the 2.0 version. Then we define that we want to store the OpenGL context by calling the setPreserved EGL context on pause method. Finally, we set the renderer used. For that, we are going to define our own OpenGL renderer. So now we need to create an OpenGL renderer class implementing the renderer class of the OpenGL API. Our OpenGL renderer implements the renderer interface defined in the GL surface view object. We implement the onSurfaceCreated method. We implement also the onSurfaceChange method. And lastly, we implement the onDrawFrame method. In the onSurfaceCreated method, we set a red color for the background of our screen. And in the onDrawFrame method, we clear the GL ES2.0 context by calling the GL clear method with a constant in parameter. GL color buffer bit. Now we can add our OpenGL view in the layout of our main activity. So we open our main layout and we write the OpenGL view that match parent size for width and height, and we define an ID. Last step is to write the Java code of our main activity. We define an OpenGL view property to store the reference to the OpenGL view defined in the activity main layout. We get the reference by calling the findViewById. Then we have just to call the onPause and the onResume method of the OpenGL view in the same method of the activity. So in the onResume, we call the onResume method, And in the onPause method of the main activity, we call the onPause method. It's really simple to start. Now, we can try our OpenGL application displaying a red background to the screen. We click on the Run button in Android Studio and we wait during the Gradle build, which can take some time. OK, the APK is installing. And now the activity is launching. You can enjoy the final result with a red background made with OpenGL. That's all for the tutorial on using OpenGL on Android. To discover the future tutorial of the series concerning OpenGL on Android, don't forget to subscribe to the SRL channel.